This is part one of how to write a number as a percent, and on this video we're going to write these numbers as a percent. There's 10 numbers here, and to do that all we do is multiply each number by 100%. First I want you to think about these two sentences. Say, I ate one whole pie, and then I ate 100% of the pie. I hope you'll agree with me that this really means the same thing, that if you eat one whole pie, that means you've eaten 100% of the pie. So here's the key idea. The number 1 and the number 100% really mean the same thing. So 1 is the same thing as 100%. They actually are equal. Now, that doesn't mean that 1 is the same as 1%, right? 1 is the same thing as 100%. So 1 is just the number, and 100% is the way of writing the number 1 using a percent sign. Okay, so that's the first idea. The second idea is that if you multiply a number by 1, you get the same number. So for instance, 4 times 1 is equal to 4, 1/2 times 1 is equal to 1/2, and so on. Well, how about replacing the number 1 with another way of writing the number 1, which is 100%. So that means instead of writing 4 times 1, I could really write 4 times 100%, and notice what happens. I have 4 times 100. I have just written the number 4 as a percent. As a percent, the number 4 is written 400%. How about the number 1/2? Same thing. I'll multiply it by 100% because that's the same thing as multiplying by 1. And then we have to do half of 100, which is 50, and we get to put our percent sign. So that's how to get a percent sign into our answer. We just multiply by 100%. And this is true whether we have a whole number or a decimal or a fraction. We haven't done a decimal yet, but we'll do that next. But notice if it's a whole number, if it's bigger than 1, it's going to be more than 100%. Because if 1 is 100%, then any number bigger than 1 is going to be more than 100%. All right, so let's try a few more problems. So here are 4 problems, and I want to write each of these as a percent. Remember, all you do is multiply by 100%. So put the video on pause and try that on your own. Okay, let's do it. So the number 3, I could simply say times 100%. Now, you don't have to put the little time sign like this. You could put a dot, you could put a parentheses around the 100, but basically you're multiplying 3 by 100. And we get 300%. You might have guessed that because 4 was 400%, 1 was 100%, so it makes sense that 3 is 300%. All right, what about the next one? Multiply by 100%. Now I'm assuming you already know how to multiply any decimal by 100, so you can multiply the when you multiply by 100, you move this decimal 2 to the right. So my answer is going to be 45, and then we have to put the percent sign. So remember, 0.45, which means 45 hundredths, is the same thing as 45%. I can't write 0.45%. I have to remember to multiply by 100 and move that decimal 2 to the right. Same thing for this next one. How about I just write it like this to show you that also means times 100%. And similar to the one above, I'd have to move the decimal 2 to the right. So what will that give me? That's one place to the right. If I move another place to the right, I'll have to put a 0 there, so I get 190%. Now, 1.9 is bigger than 1, so you would assume it would be more than 100%, which it is. And let's do the next one. Now this is a fraction. So if you're going to multiply fractions, it's usually easier to write 100 as a fraction. So instead of writing 100, you might want to write it as 100 over 1. That's optional. It's up to you. A lot of students find that easier. Okay, and now can we cancel anything? Well, the 20 does go into 100. I always cancel before multiplying the numerators and denominators if possible. So that'll be 5. So in the numerator I have 11 times 5, in the denominator I have 1 times 1. So I'm going to have 55 over 1, but any number over 1 is just the number in the numerator, so that'll be 55%. So there's a few more problems. Try this one, 0.006. So again, I'm going to multiply by 100%. And when I move the decimal place over, I still have a decimal in there. That's okay. So we have 0.6%. Now, that's correct, but keep in mind, 0.6 is less than 1, and it means 6 tenths. So you could also write this as 6 tenths %, which people think of 6 tenths of a %. And of course, you'd want to reduce that fraction. So 3/5% is another way of writing it. So either you could write that or you could write that. It means the same thing. Let's try a little bit trickier one. How about 5/6? Okay. So we're starting with a fraction and we multiply it by 100%. Since it's a fraction, let's go ahead and write it as a fraction, 100 over 1. And this time 6 doesn't go evenly into 100, but we can reduce it a little bit by dividing the top and bottom by 2. So that'll be 3 and 50. And now I have to multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. So that gives me 250 over 3%. But we don't want to leave our answer as an improper fraction. So we want to actually do division, 250 divided by 3. So let's do that over here. 3 into 250. So 3 goes into 25, 8. 3 and a remainder of 1. So that's 83 and a third. Now, notice I'm not writing it with a decimal because it's never going to end. When you're dividing something by 3, it's going to repeat a repeating decimal. So I want to write this exactly as what it stands for, which is 83 and 1/3%. So that's the same thing as just the number 5/6. So if you had 5/6 of a pie, it's the same thing as eating 83 and 1/3% of a pie. Now, if you use your calculator, you would round this. So if you took in your cal you took your calculator and you did 250 divided by 3, you would have to round. So you might write that as, if you were rounding to the nearest percent, it would end up being 83%, the nearest tenth, 83.3%. You would have to have some directions about how to round it. So as opposed to rounding it, I'm writing the exact answer, which is 83 and 1/3%. So if I were going to approximate it, you could use this little thing. It means, oh, it's close to being equal. Well, rounded to the nearest percent, it would just be 83%. That's to the nearest percent. If you're going to go to the nearest tenth of a percent, it would be 83.3%. So if you did it in your calculator, you'll notice you get 83.333 repeating. So this one would be to the nearest tenth of a percent. My rule of thumb is if I was asked to write a number as a percent, I write the exact answer unless I was directed to round. And then if I was directed to round, I would need to know what to round to, the nearest whole number, the nearest tenth, etc. Right, let's try this one. Write 2 3/4 as a percent. Well, This is more than 2, less than 3. We know that 2 would be 200% and 3 would be 300%. So you can guess it's 200 something percent. There's a few ways of doing this particular problem. One is, well, in all cases, we're just going to multiply by 100%, right? But the trick is, how do you want to do that? How do you do 2 and 3 fourths times 100%? There's more than one way people think about this problem. One way is they rewrite 2 and 3 fourths as an improper fraction. So this is method one. I could write that as 11 fourths times 100%, and then cancel. And then I've got to do 11 times 25. And that's going to be 275. Remember your percent sign. So 2 and 3 fourths from method one says the answer is 275%. And that seems reasonable because it's more than 200%, right? But less than 300%. All right, let's do another method. If you can write the fraction as a decimal that doesn't repeat, you could rewrite that 3/4 as a fraction. So if you know how to do that, then you would be able to write 2 and 3/4 as 2.75. So second method is you could write 2.75 and then multiply by 100%. And in this case, just move the decimal 2 places, and of course, we better get the same answer, 275%. And the third method, remember how we started out, 2 3/4 times 100%. You know it's going to be 200%, that's 2 times 300. Plus, I could just take that 3/4 and figure out how to write that as a percent. So 3/4 of 100%. So this will give me 200% plus, now what goes on over here, I can cancel. And that gives me 3 times 75, 3 times 25, which is 75%. And if I put the two together, I get 275% again. So if one of them is a whole number, what that's saying is you can concentrate on this part. So that's the extra 75% that we need. All right, so that was just a little bit more to it. And if you have something like 1 1/3, method two is not going to work because you can't change 1/3 to a decimal that isn't repeating. To see more examples, see my video, How to Write a Number as a Percent, Part 2.